In this short video, I'm going to show you how you can loop music tracks inside Premiere Pro. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So to get started, I'm inside Premiere Pro and I have a music track and I want to make this longer. I want to make this instead of 3 minutes, maybe 10 minutes long. And I want it to loop over and over. To do this, first switch your workspace to the audio workspace. This will bring up the Essential Sound panel. Now, if you don't see this, you can always go up to Window Essential Sound and this will display the panel. All right, so once you have that set, the next step is to grab our Remix tool. And to do that, we're going to hover over the Ripple Edit tool, long hold on it and go to the Remix tool. You should see the music icon appear. This allows you to click and drag the edge of the clip and extend it. So for example, if we can extend this out to 10 minutes, as you see squiggly lines here, and that indicates when it changes. So if we zoom in here, you can see it, by default, it loops quite often, but we can change this inside Essential Sound. So if we go into our Essential Sound panel and we go under Customize here, under Duration, we can change the amount of segments to fewer by clicking and dragging the slider to the left. And you'll notice that it loops less frequently. So it plays more of the song and then it loops less frequently. You can always hover over it and see how it sounds. So if we click play, this is how it sounds when it loops. You can see, you can kind of hear the transition. If you want to change the way it sounds, you have this variation slider. You can make it more melodic or harmonic. And it really depends on your own music track. Let's say if you go melodic, this is how this sounds. So if we go over the squiggly and click play. And then if we change it to more harmonic, this is how that sounds. I honestly can't tell the difference, but you might be able to depending on your own track. But you can change it by clicking and dragging the slider. I'm going to leave it in the middle there. So now we were able to remix this song and make it longer without having to manually cut it and extend it by hand. So this is a nice tool to keep in mind if you need to make music loop. And like I said, you can make this as long as you want. So if you need this to loop for like 30 minutes, you can keep extending this and make it as long as you need. So as you can see, we just looped it to be 55 minutes long. And the opposite is true too. Say if you wanted that 3 minute song to be 30 seconds, you can always click and drag this to only be, you know, maybe 30 seconds long. As you can see, we just changed it so that it just makes this song 30 seconds. So that's a pretty cool tool. Now, sometimes you want to loop a specific part of a song, and sometimes the remix tool doesn't work for that. So let me redo this, and I'll show you what I mean. If I re-click and drag in our audio clip into our timeline here, so let's say we have this track here and we want it to start right here and only loop for about 3 seconds or so. I'm gonna trim this audio clip by clicking Q on my keyboard. And let's say we want it to start here. And we want it to end right there. If we click W to trim the end of our clip and we want to extend this using the remix tool, sometimes it doesn't work because it's too short. For example, if we click and drag this out, you'll notice that we get a remix failed pop-up notification appear. So instead, what we have to do is manually extend this by using our selection tool. Just click on the clip, hit Command C and Command V to copy and paste it several times to paste it. And that's how you would copy and paste and loop shorter clips. You just have to find the correct beat and then just copy and paste the trim clip over and over again. And one other trick that you can do, sometimes finding the beat is tricky. If you need to zoom in, you can always go to your hamburger menu and show audio time units. This allows you to zoom in a lot further in the timeline to get the cut precise on the waveform of the audio. As you can see, our time code changed to samples rather than frames. So those are a few tools that you can use to loop audio inside Premiere Pro. But that does it for this video. We'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.